we've got touring cars coming up later. Neil Crompton's going to join us now to look at what is going to be a very high-tech touring car season.
Thank you, Gary. Over the summer break, there was considerable discussion regarding the rules governing touring car racing. After Dick Johnson's seemingly one-sided dominance of the series last year, there was a cry of equality from many entrants. But after plenty of lip service, the rules remain unchanged, and they're likely to stay that way.
Let's look at the basis of Australia's international touring car rules. In Group A, engine capacity, car weight and tyre size are all interrelated on a sliding scale to maintain equality of performance between types and brands. As you can see, engine size relates directly to the car's minimum weight. Equally, engine size also dictates wheel and tyre width, and clearly any car's ability to perform is dictated by how much horsepower and load the tyres can cope with. An example of the equation is the Holden Commodore. At 5 litres, its minimum weight is 1340 kilograms on 11-inch width rims. In order to play the touring car game, each manufacturer must have built a minimum of 5,000 of the basic type, and in order to have a competitive race car, a further 500 sporting evolutions can be built. That simply means the car has the ingredients that allow race teams to extend performance. The three main players in Australia at present are the Ford RS500 Cosworth Sierra, the Nissan Skyline GTSR, and the Holden Commodore Group A SS. All three are limited edition high-performance cousins of the basic models. The star of the show last year was clearly the Ford, and for good reason. The third in a sequence of performance models, the RS500 uses the rules to the max. Built with the rules in mind, this 2-litre four-cylinder turbo car only weighs 1,100 kilograms and enjoys ample rubber. Still climbing the development ladder, the Skyline has the potential to annoy the Sierra. A more complicated engine, this model is a rare 6-cylinder 2-litre version with 24 valves. It doesn't produce the same horsepower as the Ford, and building it down to the minimum weight has been the Nissan team's objective this season after running a heavy car last year. The Holden has no shortage of power and torque, but at 250 kilograms heavier than its nearest rivals, weight is truly a penalty. Not unusually, the Commodore is more competitive on circuits such as Bathurst, where tyre sensitivity isn't critical. Within the rules, engines, suspension, brakes and the body shell get considerable treatment. Engine mods virtually double the horsepower output on all three cars, and massive brakes and radical suspension updates make most of these cars more like a thoroughbred racer than the road chariots they loosely resemble. To give you an idea of the amount of work, the cost of a Holden, for example, blows out from a $50,000 road car to a $250,000 race car. Australia, Japan, England and New Zealand will all maintain these rules this year, while the Germans have adopted a handicap system that extends beyond these fundamental rules. To keep the competition close, turbo boost is restricted and minimum weights are altered throughout the season. That keeps the BMW M3 and the Benz 190 in with a fighting chance against the Ford in their series. In Australia this year, continued development of the Nissan and the Holden is expected to close the gap on the Fords, and the Sierras themselves are likely to be more equal as each team learns more about their cars. What's right and wrong in touring car rules depends very much on who you barrack for, and if you want to have a good debate with your mates on an issue, consider the turbo equivalency formula. It's a multiplication factor applied to the engine capacity to arrive at the true capacity of the engine after the turbo force feeds the power plant. At present, it stands at 1.7, which makes the Sierra a 3.4-litre motor car. That allows it to be 1,100 kilograms with 10-inch rims. The great turbo debate has many people wondering whether their value is really worth more than that. If the factor were 1.8, for example, that would add 80 kilograms to the Sierra. As you can see, the car was built perfectly to the rules, and the Sierra makes good use of them. The spiralling growth in the performance of turbo cars has been substantial, so much so they no longer exist in Formula One after years of debate. The issue is to be addressed at the end of this season, when Australia's touring car rules are considered for 1990 and beyond.
Thank you very much to young Einstein's brother, Neil Crompton.